I want to start with Lori today, if you'll lead us off, and give us a broad overview, if you would, of what's happening this year at Georgia's General Assembly under the Gold Dome. And for those here, everybody's interested in transparency, but what does it mean down at the Capitol, what's happening there? If you'll give us an overview, we'll take it from there.
Sure. Welcome, everyone. Make sure is the mic working? It's great to have you all here, and I'm excited to be on the panel. Tom Clyde called, left me a message yesterday. He said, okay, you have about 5 minutes. I'm like, the political reporter covering the Capitol on transparency in Georgia gets 5 minutes. So I'm going to take it really quickly if I can. But I wanted to start out with two just egregious examples of what we encountered, and probably some of you, because I know there were some journalists in the room. It's in, like, I was writing out my examples, and like, gosh, they're all the state Senate. And the state House has its own issues, but the Senate seems to make up a lot of rules that are not conducive to journalists. So I know you all remember the Don Balfour case, where he was accused of per diems and travel expenses when he was out of town. And he went before the Senate Ethics Committee, not the Ethics Commission. Now, we're talking about the Senate Ethics Committee. And we obviously wanted to follow what was happening with the case. And so we sat in the committee hearing, and the senators who were on the panel said, now everybody who is not a senator can leave. And so we politely left. And then it went a little bit further because there was a window on the door. And we started shooting through the window. They started putting tape up on the windows. You know, this is in the Georgia Capitol. To me, no meeting should be closed in the Georgia Capitol. Then the troopers came. So we had armed guards outside of a door, taped paper over the windows, at a hearing at the Georgia State Capitol. And I'm thinking, are we in China? Are we in Cuba? So we weren't able to get in there. I mean, obviously we were able to get some of the information afterwards, but it just goes to show you the power that they feel that they have, that they can close out the press in a public building. Second one, has anybody ever heard of the Senate Committee on Administrative Affairs? Yeah, I didn't either. This is a committee that meets in secret. What they discuss is always private, and I got tipped off to the fact that there was a discrimination complaint against two state senators. So we went to try to get into the meeting. We couldn't even find out where the meeting was. And what had happened was they'd settled, and it was your tax dollars, so it was $80,000. Not a lot in the whole scheme of a $20 million budget, but it was the principle of the matter, that it was your tax dollars. The way we got around it, Richard Belcher kind of worked around, was we found out it was Buckley and Klein was the lawyer for the woman involved. And we went to the Department of Administrative Services and got a check written out to Buckley and Klein on that particular day and found out it was for $80,000. So we kind of did it a back way. But again, it's a Senate Ethics Committee, and they meet in secret. They make their rules are even in secret. I mean, the Senate likes to make up their own rules. Two current pieces of legislation that I'm watching, it's kind of inside baseball, so it's not necessarily what I would report to the masses, but Senator Josh McCoon has two pieces that we're keeping an eye on. Again, it's kind of egregious when you think about it, but when senators vote on amendments on the Senate floor, there's no recording of them. They call for hand raising. So it's like they count them, 1, 2, 3, 4, aye, you know, and it's, so if you want to find out what a senator did on an amendment, how they voted, you would have to physically be in that room watching your senator either raise their hand for a yay or a nay. Senator Josh McCoon is trying to change that by saying that it has to be a recorded vote. And also we know where the conference committees, that's where they get all of the work done at the last minute. So they're negotiating last minute deals. A lot of times you can't find out where the conference committees are meeting. You can't find out who's on the conference committees sometimes. And the only way sometimes I get tipped off is if one of the lawmakers says, hey, we're meeting here. And they can't really shut you out of a conference committee meeting, but if they don't tell you where it is and you can't find it, it's kind of hard to cover. So he's got legislation, Senator Josh McCoon, that would open those up, that they would post where they are, and that they would actually lay on the table for like a day so that they're not voting on them in the last 2 hours of the session. Open records, I'm going to touch on real quickly. This has become a really difficult issue all of a sudden, and I'm glad Sam Owens is in here, the audience. I talked to a lot of reporters. I kind of took a tally in our newsroom, like what are some of the more egregious prices on these open records requests that you're getting, and it was in the hundreds and sometimes thousands of dollars. And so when we requested, this was a few years ago, I would request a defects case, an overview, it was maybe a couple hundred bucks. Well, our last one was $600, and then before then it was thousands of dollars, and we feel like it's a way for them to get around the fact that they know we can't really pay unless we all come together and pay the thousands of dollars to get around, you know, opening these cases of dead children and what happened. But the worst one, and Richard Belcher sits right next to me, and that's always fun because you can hear him yelling into the phone sometimes. That's entertainment for a reporter. It's Atlanta City Hall. I don't know how many of you have requested records from Atlanta City Hall, and it's fun. They ignore them. They don't think that they have to follow the law, right? Everybody in here is shaking their heads. And if they ignore them, they think that that will go away, or if they wait a few weeks, they would go away. Well, we don't. I mean, you guys get 3 days. They get 3 days to respond, whether it's okay, we're working on that, or they don't even respond. And I know Sam's time is precious and his dollars are precious, but it would be great even if there was some type of hotline in the AG's office, because I know you've worked in cases and won for open records, where we could say, hey, look, we're not getting these records. Could anybody from the AG's office call over instead of getting, I mean, we're lucky because WSB has some powerful attorneys who can fight our fight, but what about Valdosta Papers and some of the smaller towns that don't have, you know, the corporate lawyer backing that we do? So that is just one suggestion. It would be great if we had just, you know, where we didn't have to go to you directly or bug you directly, but some of your folks maybe in the office.
Go ahead, sir.
Maury, you talk about the state senate. They've had closed door meetings for years, even when I was down there. But did you protest it? Did you raise hell?
Yes, we did. And I mean, we publicly did that story several times with the tape windows. We ran that video over and over again. But, you know, there's a feeling there that somewhere along the lines, they forgot they're for the people. You know, some of them get it, but some of them just forget that, you know, we were elected by the people, you know, and they have, you know, kind of their own club is kind of the feeling that we get.